is Jerry Rutherford. Today, we're going to use Microsoft Excel as a drawing program. And for this example, we're going to create an in-building amplifier system. First, we need a component. And what I'm going to do is I'll show you how we did something like this antenna. We start off by going to Auto Shapes. Then what we do is select a basic shape, in this case, a trapezoid. We draw the basic outline of the antenna, and I want it rotated 90 degrees, so I simply grab this, swing it over, and we have a basic shape for an antenna. I can use this to fine-tune the look of the antenna. I can also use these to shrink it down if I want to make it wider. I can come up here and pick a color, and I can also right-click on it, add text. We'll call it A1 for antenna 1. Now, if you'll notice, the text is not really centered too well. So if we click on it once so that we get this dotted line pattern here, right-click, and then go Format Auto Shape, we can select alignment. And we can tell it we want it horizontally centered and vertically centered. Now it's very nicely centered in here. We can highlight it, select bold, and we've got something that looks really good. We need a connector for this, and the way we do a connector is very simple. You can either use the rectangle here or you can go on Auto Shapes, either one. Go ahead and draw your rectangle, and now we simply fill it in. We can come over here and we could fill it in with a simple gray, but what I like to do is go more fill effects. Fill effects. And I use gradient. Now we have this really nice gradient shaded here. And you can make it lighter if you like. Make a lighter color like this. And we have a nice light shape. Place it where you want to. Hold the control key down and select multiple items. And then with the mouse on here, right click, go to grouping and select group. Now this is one object which can be moved and rotated easily, and it can also be scaled. You can grab this and scale it to any size that you like, and then it can be placed in here. Now I'm going to slide this over a little bit, and let's say that we wanted to make a very simple antenna system. I'm going to use a command called draw border. This is not normally on your menu, you'll have to add it. Select draw border, select the wider type line, and we'll say that the antenna would start here, it would come in, it would then go down, go through an amplifier, and terminate with another antenna. That's a basic line. We'll take our antenna, place it where we want it, and there we go. Now we need to have, let's say, a lightning protector. Since I've already got one drawn, I will just go Control C to copy it, come over here, Control V to paste it, and place it where I like it. Next, we'll grab the BDA, same thing, Control C to copy it, come over here, Control V to paste it, drop it in place, and we need another antenna for the other end, for the simplest BDA I know how to make. I'm going to use this one. We're going to do a Control C to copy it, come over here, Control V to paste it, and if you notice, it's facing the wrong way. If I grab this dot, I can come around, stretch it out, place it where I want it, and you see we have a simple BDA system. Another thing that you can do is you can move your components around once you've got them placed to make it look better. Also, if you have photographs of your items, we'll delete this, for example, and use a photograph, Control-C, Control-V. Bring this photograph up in here, and I'll teach you another trick. Hold the Control key down and use your arrows, and then you can slide this right into position, and you have a very good-looking amplifier system. And that's how you do this type of drawing with Excel. I hope you enjoy the video. Thank you.